With us now for more is Multisys CEO and founder David Almirol Jr. Good to see you, David. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Kathy. Good morning.
Right. So the app has been in operation for over 2 months. You launched it right in the middle of a lockdown in April. So how many users have signed up since?
Currently, we have more than 1 million registrants already.
All right, 1 million users. So that would translate to about 1% of 100 million Filipinos?
Yes, and that's our main goal, to increase it, because contact tracing will be only efficient and effective if more people will use it.
Right, but what do you do with the data you've collected or are collecting progressively from those who register?
So currently, since this is a donation to the government, meaning everything will be stored in the government property later on. So that's the main plan.
Government property later on. So in the meantime, the data is in your hands. Is that correct?
For the moment, because migration is not easy. This is not something like a computer that you buy and just give to them. So it's a highly technical donation. So there is a transition on how to migrate everything to the government.
All right, so talk to us about that migration, because that's where the sort of uncertainty lies. You have the data in your hands and you're progressively donating that or transitioning that to the government's hands. What are you doing to ensure privacy?
We made StaySafe as an anonymized app, meaning there were no personal information in it if you use it. So that's why we even asked the guidance of the National Privacy Commission. So if you use it, you just use your mobile number, and we don't capture any basic information, no first name, no last name, no middle name, no birth date, no address. So the same app, the same technique, like what happened in South Korea and Taiwan. So. We don't see any difference.
Right, so it's just a mobile number that you capture for those who register for your app. But that's also data. So what do you do now to keep that safe?
So currently, we impose a lot of levels of security, because that's our duty to protect it. And of course, the moment that we're able to migrate this to the government, so now it will be the responsibility to store and protect it. So currently, since there's a process of migration, so we're able to establish levels of security to protect it. And of course, we're also complying with the data privacy. That's why we're able to submit all the compliances to NPC. Hopefully, they will review all those compliances soon.
The migration, when did that begin? The process of transferring the data to government, what percentage are you at and when do you hope to finish?
The first, because the first donation was happened on April by National Task Force on COVID-19. There was an intention to transfer everything to the ICT. And since this is a health data, so there was a technical working group. They formed highly technical individuals to analyze who will be the one to process this. And now there's a mandate to transfer everything to DOH. So from the ICT, now it go to DOH. So we're just following what they will tell us, because of course we did not expect that they will get our solution, Kathy, right? So so we just follow their order. For the moment, we're preparing everything so that the moment that the DOH is ready, will be able to migrate it in a fast way.
Right, just so we're clear, you didn't migrate to DICT. The data is secure in your hands, and you're just waiting for the go signal for the Department of Health to come and get it.
That is correct, because the first intention is to DICT. Now we're moving to DOH. So we're just following their instruction.
David, I was talking about the warehouse, and is this the kind of ecosystem that the government's trying to create, a data warehouse for the digital app, not just yours, but digital apps relating to COVID-19?
Yes, Kathy, that's the main intention. They should have their own data warehouse, or they should have their own cloud-based warehouse as well. So it's up to them. So for us, we'll just follow their instruction later on.
All right, now how are you resolving the integration issues? The app, I understand, recognizes Bluetooth devices using Google's Android, but you have yet to integrate this with the other platforms such as Apple's iOS.
Currently, we have the Bluetooth already integrated. We have the Android to Android, and we have also the iOS to iOS. Same thing with Singapore. Since the limitation of that old technology, it's Google and Apple cannot integrate altogether because of that limitation. That's why we're able also to add the GPS on it to make sure that it will be seamless. So now Apple gave us the API. They just gave us like 3 days ago, since DOH approved StaySafe to be the contact tracing. So my team is now integrating the new API to make sure that even iOS and Android can link up altogether using the Bluetooth technology.
Right, so just to confirm, this GPS is going to resolve this impasse between the different operating systems.
That is correct, that is correct.
And would you be needing a final approval from the government? And which agency would be in charge of this?
Once we're able to integrate the new exposure notification of Apple and Google, we will be removing also the GPS. Because the reason why we embed the GPS because of the past or the old limitation of the Android iOS notification. But now we have the API. We just got it 3 days ago, Cathy. So my team is doing their best to finish everything this week, so that we'll be able to make it purely a Bluetooth contact tracing.
So there is no need for you to seek government approval, is that correct?
They might approve it again, but currently, since we got the approval already to continue the integration, so our job is to finish the integration.
Right. You know, there have been allegations that you had been favored early on. How were you vetted?
We presented, you know, we developed StaySafe for our own use, Cathy. We did not even intend to give to the government, you know, because we're quite, we would like to prepare also, it comes for worst. We would like to present also to PLDT to use it, because we would like to have like a protection also to our employees. So when I was quite amazed on the development of StaySafe, and we think that it could also save lives, so we're able to present to so many government agencies. So happened that we had a chance to present to NTF. So in terms of being favored, I think that's quite unfair, because there's a lot of people there. There's a lot of brilliant minds out there who saw the system, you know, in front of so many IT companies as well. So I think they are fair and brilliant enough to understand that we have the best solution, Cathy.
It's a happy problem you now have, having to be the official contact tracer. But there have been questions, and this comes from Eliseo Rio Jr. as well, the government's decision to choose just one digital contact tracer when there should be multiple ones. To solve the complex issues all over the Philippines. He cites your app only works on 3G-capable phones and newer models. So that leaves out around 20 or so million Filipinos using 2G devices. Is that true?
No. If I would like to have more apps, if possible, you know, because it's nice to have like collaboration to multiple IT companies. But it so happened that Google and Apple only they would like to give only one API per country. So meaning, how could we use multiple apps and contact tracing if even Apple and Google, they have their own policy to give only one API exposure for the notification of Bluetooth combining iOS and Android. So it's not even our decision. It's even a decision of Apple and Google. So that's the reason why we need only one app, because of that limitation of access that they're giving us. Second is, if the problem is all about the 2G, if Eliseo Rio called me because he's even sat down on some of our meetings, so he even mentioned to me about a lot of appreciation about StaySafe that time, you know. So it's quite shocking on those kind of comments, because if the problem is just the 2G, it's easy, you know. What we're gonna do is we just need to like make StaySafe lighter so that it can also run in 2G. So that's easy, Cathy. You know, if they just only ask us to prepare also StaySafe into a 2G environment, so that's easy to do.
So will you take on the challenge? Or are you doing it already?
We're doing it already. So that's why the new app that we'll be launching together with DOH that could cater both 2G and 3G as well, Kathy.
But the intention really is to, as you said, and I wanted to confirm if this was correct, that you were willing to have other players take part in the whole ecosystem and not just one company like yourself providing all the apps to the government for contact tracing. Is that correct?
That is correct. We're willing to do that, but there's a limitation because Apple and Google, they cannot issue multiple APIs to multiple mobile apps, Kathy. That's the major problem now.
Understood. So how much have you invested in staysafe.ph?
We did not expect that to be investing so much because our plan is just to give to them and then let them run it right after we develop StaySafe. To be honest, we're quite shocked also on the expenses now because we're handling the cloud and people, and we also help the government implement nationwide. Imagine how many LGUs that we have to train, right? We have like more than 1,600 LGUs. So, well, we're already here. So as long as we're helping and for the better good, I think that will pay us already, Kathy.
So how much have you invested or are investing?
In our approximation, maybe around 10 to 15 million already. Especially we also use some promotions and even SMS blasting. And in fact, even Eliseo Rio also help us to promote StaySafe. That's why it's quite odd that he's talking bad things about StaySafe, because I believe that he was one of the supporters of StaySafe during the first implementation. So we're quite happy that we're progressing and the government is really doing their best. They formed a lot of technical working groups. They combined the effort of the ILG, the ICT, DOH, and supported by IATF and NTF. So hopefully everything will be implemented soon nationwide, Kathy.
Right, and we all have the same goal, just the same. It's to save everyone's lives, every single Filipino life. Thank you so much. I appreciate you coming on, David. You keep well. David
Almiron
of Multisys Technologies Corporation.
Thank you so much.